My Mercury is Vargottama. Why am I not a king? My sun is Vargottam. Why am I working under somebody? These are questions which people ask sometimes when they do not know about Vargottam planets. Okay. So today we shall discuss these myths and lies about Vargottama planets and why they are always overhyped, and what actually does a Vargottama planet mean, and what does it do actually? All right, and what will happen if you have a planet which is Vargottama? Okay, so first let's discuss what is a Vargottama planet. You might have seen this word. Yes, Varga Uttam. This means if a planet is in the same zodiac sign in your Lagna chart and in your Navamsha chart. Which means, let's talk with an example. Suppose your Mercury is in Pisces in your Lagna chart, and also in your Navamsha, it's in Pisces. Just an example. So then you can say my Mercury is Vargottam, or even if it's in Virgo here and Virgo there, whichever zodiac sign, any of the 12 zodiac signs, okay. So then it is known as Vargottam. There's another concept known as Bhavottam. Bhavottam means it is in the same house in both Lagna chart and the Navamsha chart. So suppose you have Mercury in third house in both the horoscopes, then it is Bhavottam. And if your Lagna is Vargottam, then it means, like for example, you have the same Lagna in both the divisional charts. Okay, so you can call it Vargottam or Bhavottam Lagna, either ways you want. So then, of course, yes, if your Lagna is the same in both D1 and D9, then the chances of planets being both Vargottam and Bhavottam, if it is either one of them, increases. Okay, it becomes 100%, because then it will be in the same house and sign. But what does it mean when you say I have a Vargottam planet? Why is the concept of Vargottama only assigned to the Navamsha? Of course, now if you have a planet which is in the same sign in D1 and in D10, then it can have certain effects in your career field. But what does it mean when you have a planet in same sign in the D1 and in the D9? So this means that energy of that planet is coming unadulterated. What does it mean? It means there is no difference between in and out. In and out means when you are alone with yourself, nobody is around you, what you are thinking is exactly that which you are doing when you are with somebody else. And that somebody can be anybody, your spouse, your mother, father, anybody. And therefore, they say a Vargottam planet is very prominent. They say it's very powerful. Now, very careful with the words. And yes, I forgot to say, if you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it down below. And if you want a consultation from me regarding your Vargottama planets, then you can always go to the website down in the description section. Okay. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him, and he will help you to use your Vargottam planets properly. So now the thing is, these, very careful with the statements here. There is no statement in any scripture which says Vargottam planet is going to be extraordinarily good. Okay. So therefore, from now on, what you hear might disappoint you. This may not be what you have heard. Okay. And I have done a lot of sessions with Amanji and Gitanshuji last week and the weeks before, if you would have seen, to demystify these misconceptions. So this video is another part of that. Okay. So what does it mean when, so now suppose people think that if they have a Vargottama planet, they will become king. So one person told me, he read somewhere he saw, he heard some other astrologer told him that if anybody has sun Vargottama, then the person becomes a king. Okay. So now there's a long list of in which rashis a planet can be Vargottam, okay, in which degree and all this. So there are so many possibilities that a planet can be Vargottam. So that means there should be so many kings born, right? Throughout the year, I mean. If somebody has Sun Vargottam, then there must be many kings. And somebody says if Moon is Vargottam and the person is a lady, then she's like a queen who is reborn. Well, then there should have been so many queens. Today you would have seen so many kings and queens going on with as in Sanskrit they say, mukut, crowns. But it doesn't seem like that. Okay, so therefore, you have to understand why the Rishi said that a Vargottam planet is very prominent. Because in general, if you look at the Vedic ethos, it was very much recommended to be clean in and out, which means the scriptures always advise that what we are inside and what we are outside, there should not be difference. There is a harmony between that. Okay. Now, this does not mean to say that is one approach. The other approach is that you be sensitive and caring to people. So, suppose you don't like somebody, then it doesn't mean, you go and tell them in the face, I don't like you, I hate you. Rishi said, inside, outside should be same. No, that's nonsense. Inside, outside is same means that what you think and what you do should be in line. So, suppose you want to do something. What you want to do is the Navamsh. And what you end up doing is the Lagna chart. Should I repeat? What you want to do is the Navamsh. And what you end up doing and what happens after you do, that is the Lagna chart. Okay. So therefore, the Rishi suggests that there should be there should not be an ambiguity between these two. Okay. But there is a certain pretext to that, which means there is an assumption that you are a good person before that. Okay. So suppose there is a criminal or a murderer, he wants to murder somebody. Then inside he wants to murder. And then is it good if he goes and murders externally? Well, that's definitely not good. So you have to understand the biggest problem with astrology is people, they don't know how to interpret the context of the slokas. So in some book, there is a sloka written, but do you know what is the context of that? Which means suppose somebody goes to do a master's. So then there is a prerequisite that you must have done bachelor's in that domain. Yes, I mean, not necessarily, but you must have done bachelor's somewhere. You may do engineering and do a MBA, Master of Business Administration. That's fine. But you cannot say that I will just give my 10th or 12th exam and then I will go and do MBA. That may be possible, but very rare cases. Unless you are like extraordinarily talented. Maybe you have a super resume or something like this. Or if you say, I have just done my 10th or my 12th and I want to do PhD. Well, that's also difficult. So a person who is applying for a master's in a university, the professor who is checking his or her resume already expects that you have done bachelor's. Now, of course, if you have not done, then your application may be rejected. That's pretty obvious. But it's human to expect that, right? That you have applied for a master's program. That means you must have done bachelor's. So similarly, when the Vedic scriptures are saying something, there is always a pretext to it. There is a context around which it is said. Okay, so to interpret such statements, you have to understand there is an assumption that your behavior is good or you are supposed to be good. In general, not that you have to be, you are perfect actually. So therefore, when you interpret such statements, then you have to understand why, because it's very surprising. Somebody said that, Vargottam, I mean, suppose a planet is indicating bad things, then we will also end up doing that. So how come that is good? Yes, that's a legitimate question. So therefore, the conclusion about Vargottama is A Vargottama planet provides you with that inner strength to do things which you want to do externally. Okay. So now, suppose you have a planet Vargottama in your chart. Okay. So what it means is that you have a greater capacity to use that planet for its ultimate ultimate purpose. Okay. Which means you have been blessed by Lord Vishnu especially, so that you can now, there's no barrier between what you want to do and what you should do. Okay. So therefore, if you have a planet which is Vargottama, you should consider yourself very fortunate. Now, one thing which people forget to analyze is the nature of that planet, the nature and what that planet is doing actually. So for example, many times people tell me that this planet is Vargottama, but then why that is not happening? So let's talk with an example. Suppose somebody says, oh, my 10th lord is Vargottama, but why am I suffering in career? I am suffering miserably, terribly, horribly. Why is that happening? Well, 10th lord is Vargottama, but what if your 10th lord is in a dusthana, like 6, 8 or 12, or if it is in debility? So that means, now what happens? The same Vargottama planet, which is Vargottama, is also debilitated. Okay, so many times people play this plus minus. So they think, oh, if a planet is in debility and if it is Vargottama, then the debility is cancelled. No, it is not cancelled. It is amplified. What does it mean? It is amplified. Now, the person might act depending on the entire horoscope. The person might act in ways which he or she regrets later. Okay. Now, I don't mean to say this is very bad for the entire horoscope. What I mean to say is, suppose a planet is there in the sixth house, or suppose your sixth lord is Vargottama, like I gave you the example for the 10th lord. So suppose your sixth lord is Vargottama, okay, or your sixth house has a planet, let's take example of we took Mercury, Sun, Moon, let's take Rahu. Suppose you have Rahu in sixth, okay, and your Rahu is Vargottama. So what does it mean? It means that Rahu's power to grant you celibacy is immensely strong. So what can happen during Rahu Dasha is, because it's in the sixth house, there can be a need of separation or from the spouse, or I mean physical separation could be there. Maybe you have some war because of which you are busy, you are not able to give time to your spouse. Or because Rahu is a natural malefic, there can be fights if you are already married. And if you are not married, and if you want to get married, it may be difficult. But now, because it is also Vargottama, which means it is in the same sign in the Navamsa chart. Therefore, what will happen is, let's talk with an example. So suppose you are not married and your Rahu is in sixth and it is Vargottama. Okay. So then, depending on the entire horoscope, it can happen that because it's in sixth in Lagna, you are trying to find proposals to get married, but somehow you are not able to find. Now suppose you find somebody, okay, but because in Navamsha it is also in the same sign, that means now you will also not like that person who you end up meeting. So you yourself will say, no, I don't want to marry this person. You yourself will decide, because that energy which is there inside of you and outside of you, that is in harmony. So it's like saying, externally it is difficult to get married, and then internally also you are not liking that person, and externally there could be some other problem. Like I gave the example recently in one of my videos that one couple, their marriage was fixed, and one day or the day before the wedding, or I guess it was one day or around that same time, the grandfather or grandmother expired. And in India, there's this tradition that you should not marry for 1 year if some elder passes away. So marriage was delayed for 1 year. So it's like saying your marriage got postponed by 1 year, and you are also happy because you don't want to marry that person. It's a very tricky scenario. Even if the sixth lord is Vargottama, then also these things can happen. okay? Because your need for, not need, I would say, the flavor of celibacy is very prominent, which means you don't like that person and somehow that person also doesn't like you, all right? This can happen depending on the entire horoscope, or especially if you have too many planets in Virgo, okay? But now there is this dynamic situation. So imagine somebody has a very prominent Venus, okay? This is where Vargottama planets can actually give you suffering. They can make your life miserable, terrible, and give you a hellish experience. Okay, sorry to say like this, but I have to break these myths which are there. Otherwise, people are ruining and destroying their lives by spending so much money, by doing so many remedies, and getting into so much anxiety because of these Vargottama planets. Okay, I know the gravity of the situation. That is why I am telling all this. People are deciding marriages when they are doing compatibility, especially in India, in arranged marriage scenario. I know people who tell me that, oh, the man, and this man sees that, oh, this girl has a Vargottam Venus. So the astrologer told I should go and marry this girl. And I'm like, what if that Venus is in 6,000? Then what? Then that 6th house energy is Vargottam. That means the day she sees you or you get married, she will distance herself from you. Alright, so this is huge, actually, I'm telling you. So when there is this dynamic situation, so let's example somebody, take an example, as I said. Why I'm taking 6th house? Because most of the questions are related to career and marriage. Okay. So 6th house is the only house which kind of denies you marriage but gives you a job. So it's a very harmonious energy for this situation. So now suppose your Rahu is in 6th, or you have any planet in 6th, okay, or your Ketu is in 6th and it is Vargottam. So then that means this distancing with the spouse can be there externally and internally, okay. Many times you will see people, they don't like the spouse, but they will not divorce. They will just stay there somehow. Alright. So, that is like saying, you are not getting an opportunity to divorce or due to some reason, or due to society pressure or social norms or religious norms, you are not doing it. Okay. But sometimes you will see people want to stay together, but they are not able to stay. So this is the opposite scenario. Okay. So now suppose somebody has a planet in 6th, which is Vargottam. Or let's assume the 6th Lord is Vargottam. Okay. Then, on the contrary, the person has too many planets in either the 5th house or the 7th house. Or in Libra. Either of these cases. Why do I say this? Because the 5th house is the house of love and romance, when connected to the 8th house and the 12th house. And in itself, it's the house of the child. And when connected to the 9th house, it is the house of mantra, guru mantra. Okay. So now, suppose this person has a Vargottam planet in 6th, or the 6th Lord is Vargottam. And you have these fancy planets, especially planets like Moon or Venus. I have seen if they have these Moon or Venus either in 5th or 7th, then these people, or in Lagna, okay, or if Venus is the Lagna Lord, most of the times they are crazy for relationships. Crazy, by saying crazy, I don't mean they are very desperate or they are very much they do wrong things. I don't mean to say that, but what I am saying is if Moon or Venus are placed in these houses, okay, 1, 5, 7, or they are ruling these houses, then generally I have seen that relationships are very important in their life, which means even if they have everything but they have difficult relationships, they are not happy. They may be they may be millionaires, billionaires, trillionaires, but they are not happy. Okay, so, and then if you have a Vargottam planet in 6th, or your 6th Lord is Vargottam, this can be really challenging, okay? Because now these thoughts of love, romance, creativity, fun, enjoyment, you know, opposite sex, and all these things are going on in your head, maybe. And then On the other hand, you are forced to stay with somebody you don't like, or that person doesn't like you back. All right. So in these cases, the Vargottama planet is the most difficult and the most miserable planet which you can have. Okay. But now let's take an example, the opposite case. Suppose your moon is in the ascendant, or you have Venus in seventh, or moon is in the fifth, Venus in fifth. Okay. Or even if they are lording these houses, I have seen. And then you have a Vargottam planet in the seventh house. Wow. that's like a king. King doesn't mean you are just like going on having big empires, but having a very nice, very beautiful married life. That these days, in fact, I would say these people are king actually, because there are many people who have money, but most of the people don't have good relationships these days. Earlier times, people didn't used to have money, but nowadays they have so much money, but they are unhappy inside. Okay. Or suppose your seventh lord is Vargottam, and then you have Jupiter in the ascendant, or your second lord is Vargottam. That sense of family is there. Okay. So you will always maintain your family. You will have very good relationship with your family members, depending on the entire horoscope, of course. Now, many of you will write, oh, you are speaking lies. My guru is Vargottam. I have miserable relationships with my family. No, it doesn't work like that. What I mean to say is, if your second house is prominent, and then added to that you have Jupiter Vargottam, okay, then it's a great blessing. Okay. Or if you have Jupiter aspecting the moon, because then these people are generally, they are very far-sighted and they are more forgiving in general. Okay. So therefore, before you make fancy conclusions about Vargottama planets, try to analyze the context in which that planet is Vargottam, which means, is that planet's Vargottam behavior supporting the entire horoscope? Yes or no? If it is not supporting, then that planet is like a curse. If it is supporting, it is like the greatest blessing that you can have. Okay. So therefore, I gave the example. If you have a Vargottam planet in sixth, but somehow you're, and then of course, dashas, you must never forget dashas. Okay. Whatever happens depends on your dashas. So now let's take this same example. Suppose your sixth lord is Vargottam, or you have a Vargottam planet in sixth house. But suppose that planet's Mahadasha doesn't come in your life. And then on the other hand, you have very good planets sitting in the fifth or seventh or ninth or the second. And then these Mahadashas are coming. Okay, so suppose you have sun in second, then you have moon in fifth. Let's take some best case scenarios. And then you have Mars in ninth. Okay, so Sun Mahadasha, Moon Mahadasha, Mars Mahadasha. So Sun is 6 years, Moon is 10 years, Mars is 7 years. Okay, so it's a big time. There you see almost 2 decades. So now if you are, if you get married at 25, then almost till 40, 45, 45 or maybe 50 also, depending on your entire horoscope, you will have a very good married life with these placements. 2, 5, 7, 9. These are very good houses. These are the best houses of the horoscope. Okay, for marriage especially. And 11th house, of course, not to forget. And then suppose you have this Rahu in the 6th. Then it won't matter much. But suppose you are running Rahu Mahadasha, then it's a real tough job. Alright, so that planet, even though it is going against the horoscope, may not be that terrible. Because you will not run the Mahadasha of that planet in this life. Or suppose you run the Mahadasha when you are 80. So then also it may not matter much, especially in that area of life. Okay. But suppose you are running that Mahadasha at the age of 30, then it will matter a hell lot, especially if it is marriage or career. Okay. And it will matter for every area, in fact. All right. So let's take on a last example for a child, education time. Okay. So now, if a child is getting back-to-back fantastic Mahadashas after the age of 40, so then it's like you can always learn. There is no age to learn, of course. This is the proverb. You can learn at any age. But they say, no, that bamboo is most flexible when it is new. So then comparing that to a child who gets a fantastic Mahadasha, suppose Jupiter Mahadasha, no? Very long, 16 years. So suppose that person gets it at the age of 10 to 26. So by that time, this child would have passed his preliminary school, master's, bachelor's, or maybe gets into PhD also by 26. Into PhD, not completing PhD, of course. So then that's fantastic. Okay. So that therefore, before you make fancy conclusions about Vargottam planets, you should check what is the nature of that planet. What does that planet signify? Do you have that in your life? If you have, you are happy. If you don't, you are miserable. Okay. So if you are giving predictions to somebody just on the basis of some blind statement that Vargottama planets are good, then your predictions will end up in a disaster. They will end up in a catastrophe. Okay. And then you check what is the entire horoscope telling. Where is the flow? Is this Vargottam planet flowing or is it opposing? Okay. Because nothing can oppose the horoscope. Because it's like nine people sitting together and they will vote. So if one person says, I won't vote, so then the team will suffer, but he will suffer more. Okay. Because he is going against all of these. Okay. So if the Vargottam planet is going against the agenda of the entire horoscope, that planet really suffers. You will suffer in traits of that planet. Okay. And then you check dashas. Okay, so you have to use these principles to judge if a planet is Vargottam and that if a Vargottam planet is good or bad for you. Okay, so therefore, don't just keep making fancy statements like, oh, I have my son Vargottam, I should be a king. Well, you may be king, but if sun is in the seven, maybe you have a very good married life, provided your horoscope supports that, okay, and your dashas agree, conditions apply, then you are a king of relationships, may not be of some country. And if it is related to the 10th house and the 11th house, then you may be the king which you think a king is, all right. There you go. Thank you very much for your patience. And as usual, if you're new, then please subscribe to the channel. And if you want a consultation from me, then you can go down to the description section. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him.